So, do you guys remember when it used to be fun to make art and to draw and to do things that you generally loved doing? Because sometimes we can kind of get caught up in just creating as creators. We just get caught up in pushing out endless supplies of work and drawings and constant updating, and you start to realize that, hey, I'm not having fun anymore, and this is not great. And so you kind of take a step backwards and you're like, what the heck? What happened? Why can't I get back to that feeling or that time period where I used to enjoy creating things? And that's kind of where I'm at in the past couple of weeks. Nothing major is going on. It's just that I kind of stopped having fun when I was drawing. And I'm trying to break out of it still, but I think I finally kind of broke free when I started this piece. And the whole reason I started it is because I was feeling a little clustered with all the self-inflicted deadlines and self-inflicted sort of standard I was holding myself to with my art and posting and updating everything. And that's not always a healthy thing to do. While it's good to have deadlines and personal projects and stuff that you want to accomplish, sometimes you can kind of psych yourself out when you have to endlessly push out product and endlessly create things for an audience, and yeah, it's not very good. But this piece is something I kind of wanted to do because it was something that I generally enjoyed doing a couple of years ago, or maybe just a year ago, was I would just love creating like these kids that were like half monsters or just like gross in a certain way. They'd always have like a half human face, half monster face. And it was just something that I really loved doing back when I first started digital art, or even did some traditional art. I made like little stickers of these. I kind of wanted to get back into it recently because I was like, hey, I missed that. That was fun. Why haven't I done that in a while? And well, it may be because I just kind of gotten out of the habit of it. I kind of want to focus more on my comic, which is fine. I'm still doing my comic, but you kind of want to go back to what you love without just completely forgetting what you're doing now. And yeah, that's just kind of why I started this thing. It's completely different than anything I've posted recently or anything I've got on my YouTube channel. But it was something that I really loved doing a while back, and I kind of wanted to just feel that emotion again. And I don't know if it's some sort of imposter syndrome where you just feel like you have to create certain things at a certain time for a certain type of audience. And if you don't do it a certain way, you kind of feel like, who am I? Like, what am I even doing? This is wrong. This isn't me. And I don't want that feeling. I'm talking a lot metaphorically and stuff, but art has a lot to do with your emotions and vice versa. And once you realize that, you can still create a certain type of art while eventually stopping a certain style that you're doing and then just taking time to do something else completely different, completely random, and a style that you don't normally do. It's okay to do both. It's okay to one day want to draw chibis and then the next day you're drawing like gore or something. I don't know. It's art. It can be anything you make it, honestly. Like, there's no limits except for the limits that you place for yourself. I don't know. That's vague. It's fine. It's art. But yeah, recently it was just a feeling and I didn't like the feeling. And so that's why I did this. And I'm pretty sure I just said that. But I'm drinking an entire caffeine drink, so I'm kind of hyper right now. But anyway, yeah, this drawing is just me trying to get that feeling again. And I'm still probably gonna do more like it. I don't really know. But I'm still working on my comic and it's going by very slowly. Yeah, it's going by very slowly. Work and my one day off, I have school. Just deep sigh. Okay, anyway, yeah, the comic is going to be posted. I don't even know if I'll post an episode this month. It's already Valentine's Day, and I'm only on page like 4 of the comic that is completely done of a couple of pages. I haven't even gotten to dialogue. It's just setting up the chapter with like a tree and my boy Bram and a bird flying, and I'm kind of wanting to draw some more animals so you can get the setting, blah blah blah. Yeah, but that's not really the topic of this video, so I guess I can just kind of circle back to what I was talking about. Yeah, but like, I don't know, I used to have fun when I was drawing, and sometimes it's not fun to draw, and I don't like that. It shouldn't be a burden, it shouldn't be something that you have to force yourself to do. I mean, it's always nice to make time for art and to do your personal projects while still completing, you know, your side projects and everything that you are building up to your career or just for fun. But you just gotta have a passion for it, just like anything in life. I don't really feel passionate about my job, but I still do it. But when aspects of things that you make a hobby or a personal time environment, I don't know. People do things all the time. I just do art. But you just want to make time and effort for it. And if it's not fun, then it's just like, what's the point? Why am I even doing it? It shouldn't be a burden to do things that you want to, you know, enjoy doing. And this is very, very long-winded and very redundant, but I'm just trying to put this into my head while I'm talking to you guys, because I'm trying to like do a Jedi mind trick on myself to make myself realize that it's okay to stop pressuring yourself into doing things, and it's okay to want to do things just for fun. You don't have to create 100% perfect art all the time. Sometimes you can make ugly art. I don't care. Do what you want, as long as you're being creative and you're not hurting people. It's fine. But wow, I'm out of breath. Yeah, I just really had fun with this piece, and it took me a couple of days to complete the whole process, like the finishing touches and stuff. I didn't really get to show because I had to finish it while I was at work. So I had to download the file onto my iPad and then finish it on the iPad at work, so I couldn't record the entire last details and stuff, which I really love doing, but also this video would have been like 30 minutes long. Nobody wants to see that. So yeah, I liked the colors in the end, and the color scheme that I do is actually not gonna be in the video, unfortunately, because I kind of added a last minute gradient scheme, and it's got this nice background. It's just a solid color. I don't like the background that I have in the video right now. I didn't know what I was doing with it. I just kind of made it like a tie-dye lime green and orange thing. It wasn't working out. I just wanted to do a solid color. So at the end, I did a solid color of like a red. I had like three different versions of it, but I'll show my favorite version first. But I had like this bluish, purplish, reddish color scheme, and I just really liked the way that the colors played off of each other. And he had this creepy, eerie effect while still being kind of like nasty and frightening and cute, I guess. I don't know. But yeah, this is just a very long-winded reverse way of saying, do what you want, do what you love, don't pressure yourself into doing things all the time, because then you won't like what you're doing and you'll just be like a machine. We aren't meant to be machines. That's why we have iPhones and computers and everything else, because they can do things endlessly until they break, but we're not built like that. We need to do things that we like, or else we just kind of fall apart and whine and can't sleep or everything else that humans go through. But yeah, that's my whole rant and very loose explanation of everything I just said. I'm not good at summarizing. I'm not an English major. My sister is. I'm just the weirdo that just draws monsters, and yeah, that's all I do. But anyway, on a personal side note, I just got out of my special effects class earlier today. We're not having class next week, and I'm sad, but yes, we finally got our life casts, so we got to see our faces cemented basically out of plaster, and it looks like I'm dead. It's awesome. And we're gonna start making our monsters the following week, and I'm excited. I don't know what the heck I'm doing sculpting, but I've got a general idea. Don't know how I'm gonna execute it, but that's why I have a teacher. she'll help me out maybe. And I can show off my monster eventually on Instagram and stuff. So if you want to keep up with that process, I am sharing everything on my story. And yeah, all my future comic stuff is going to be on my story as well. I mostly post on Instagram because I'm lonely and need validation. But yeah. I hope y'all have a great day or night, afternoon, evening, I don't know. I will see y'all in my next video that probably won't be a half monster boy. Who knows? We'll see. I don't know. I don't know anything. Bye!